Did you enjoy the keynote today, buddy? Okay, buddy. I know. Well, that was disappointing. Okay, so WWDC 21 is a wrap, or 2021, whatever. It's finally a wrap. It's good. All the speculations and all the stuff come to a conclusion. And we were all wrong, mostly. To start out, Tim said good morning. That's a plus. We had a very interesting intro with the developers. Thought it was cool. Okay, so let's get into it. Air Force One, Craig, comes out and talks about iOS 15. Starting off with FaceTime has some new features. Has spatial audio for FaceTime, which I think is pretty cool. Probably works with only AirPods Pro and AirPods Max. They didn't really confirm or deny anything. Another feature, voice isolation, then wide spectrum, which is the exact opposite. Voice isolation cuts all the background noise just so you can hear your voice. Wide spectrum is the opposite, where they have everything. You can hear the orchestra behind you or whatever. Next is grid view, which is kind of like how Zoom has, how it has person here, person here, person here, whatever. And then whoever's talking is kind of highlighted. So that's cool. FaceTime links, which also works with Android, so that's a thing. So I could be wrong on this, and if I am wrong, let me know. Why is there no center stage? I figured that would just be a software thing. My 12 Pro Max has a wide angle camera on the selfie cam, but so why is there no center stage? I'm probably missing something, but I was kind of thinking that would be a thing, but it's not, unfortunately. The new SharePlay API, which will also work with other developer apps coming soon. Screen sharing, audio sharing over FaceTime, and that also works with picture-in-picture, and it will thread to Apple TV, so that's really cool. So that's some pretty cool stuff. Okay, now on to Messages. Messages has a couple of new things, photo collage design and messaging, to make your photos more sleek and look better when you're sharing photos through Messages. There is a Shared With You section in a plethora of new apps, News, Apple Music, Photos, Safari, Podcasts, and Apple TV. All will have a Shared With You. So if somebody shares a song with me, I'll go into the Apple Music app and I'll have a Shared With You section. That song will be there. Same thing if somebody sent me a link to a thing. If I go to the News app, it'll be there, shared with me. So that's kind of cool. Okay, next is a big thing called Focus. Focus gives some notifications. Essentially, how they put it is it helps your focus on your phone be based on your focus physically. Sure, what a thing. Live text takes text from photos and make it into actual text, understands 7 languages. Cool, I think live text is awesome. Spotlight will quickly be able to find photos from Spotlight search, so you won't have to scroll all the way through your photos to find a new photo. And then you can also find a contact through Spotlight and then easily message them or whatever. So that's kind of cool. Honestly, didn't know that wasn't a thing already. Memories from the Photos app been given an update. Now has Apple Music tracks in the background and based on, you know, what's going on. So if you're on top of a mountain, on top of the world from Imagine Dragons will be playing or something like that. And then you can choose mixes that you want. You can choose different songs and filters, whatever. Okay, I thought this was pretty cool. Wallet now has a house key. So that's kind of like car key, but it's a house key. So I assume you have to get a new lock for your house, you know, fob, and your phone has that built in. So I think that is really, really cool. Like if my best friend wants to come over, I can share my house key with him. If he wants to, like, you know, take care of my cat while I'm out of town or something, I can share my house key with him through the phone. And while I'm out of town, he can still use that to come in. And apparently it's very secure. Also works with your work badge key thing and a hotel key. Also my favorite thing, your ID is now in the wallet app. I think that is amazing. I don't know who will accept it, how many people will accept it, but there's so many times where I forget my wallet at home. And this will help so much. I love it. I can't wait for that to be a thing. Okay. Weather and Maps also have some new features. Weather has a new redesign, some new graphics and animations, and full screen maps of the temperature and conditions. So that's kind of cool. Maps now shows buildings and elevations, landmarks, has a nighttime mode with a moonlit glow. New road details while driving, crosswalks and all that stuff. Has a lot of new things. Okay, AirPods Pro and AirPods Max, I'm assuming. We'll also get some new updates in iOS 15. Conversation boost with AirPods Pro. Essentially, if somebody's talking to you while you're wearing AirPods Pro, their voice will be louder, amplified. That's the word. Now, with Siri, notifications is now a thing. Instead of just messages, all notifications. AirPods Pro and Max have Find My. It's kind of like having an AirTag built in. So you can have, you know, the API where you're looking and the thing. That's really cool. I forgot what they called it. Spatial audio in tvOS is really awesome because I just got an Apple TV and I can use spatial audio with my AirPods when I'm watching on the big TV. So I think that's epic. And spatial audio with Max with M1 as well. That's cool. Dolby Atmos in Apple Music, which we already knew about. Okay. iPadOS. We all thought something awesome and big was coming. No. One, Craig didn't say jiggle mode. When he announced the widgets all across the home screens like we thought. New larger widgets for the iPads, app library. So essentially iOS 14 for the phone. For all the things that didn't come to iPadOS are now on iPadOS. Multitasking has some new updates. Life is a little bit easier when it comes to multitasking. Notes has some cool updates. Translate, and then on Swift Playground you can make apps on iPads. But that's it. Nothing really else to take advantage of your new M1 iPad Pro. Yay. Unfortunate. Privacy has some new stuff, like always. Siri and iCloud. iCloud has a new feature called iCloud Plus, which has a private relay, hide my email, and HomeKit secure video. So enhances privacy in all three of those aspects. Health got a couple of new things. Mobility. It will keep track of your mobility and your fall risk, and if it increases or not, and it'll give you a notification. So more beneficial health things for people who struggle with these sort of issues. Labs, keep track of your lab data, like if you have blood work done. They test like 50,000 different things and none of them make sense. So they put it in the labs thing on the health app, and it kind of breaks it down for you and gives you an explanation of what some of them are. And my cat's playing with the bell. Fantastic. Trends, recognizes trends and data. So if you have a sleep trend, if something changes, it'll notify you. So that's kind of cool. Then family health. So if I want to share my health settings on my app, not settings, my health things on my health app with my wife or with my parents or something, I can. So that's really cool. I like that a lot. Now on to Watch OS. There's an enhanced breathing app. There's a reflect app. So that's kind of cool. You know, just hey, sit back for a moment and reflect on how great your life is. That's fine. Sleep now has a respiratory rate. So essentially it tracks your respiratory rate while you're asleep. And it will just, you know, let you know if in the trends thing if there's something out of whack. Then there's also two new workouts, Tai Chi and Pilates. Two that I don't do. There's more Fitness Plus workouts and then Spotlight Series artist stuff. Great. New portraits, watch face. Redesigned Watch Photos app, so that's kind of cool. More intuitive. Gifts now on the Apple Watch. Fantastic. New home features. We all thought it would be called Home OS, but it wasn't. It's called nothing really. So there's a couple new home features to take advantage of the FaceTime stuff or Home Key and all this stuff. So yeah. Okay, Mac OS Monterey. iUpdate was talking about this. He guessed the name beforehand. I thought that was awesome. Has new FaceTime capabilities from iOS, SharePlay and screen sharing, share with you, focus, all of that is on Mac as well. Continuity, universal control S. So I think this is kind of cool. I can't make any use of it because I don't use a Mac. If you watched my last video, you know. My iPad is my everything. My entire life is on my iPad Pro and I love it and I will never get rid of it. Universal control is essentially your iPad is now a better sidecar to the Mac. With immediate cursor support. So if you're on your Mac book or whatever using the trackpad, your iPad's right next to it, your Mac automatically knows that your iPad's right next to it. You can move the cursor and it automatically goes to the Mac. And it's automatically a second screen wirelessly. It's really cool. Networks between three different devices, so you can have, in the keynote they had, a Mac, a MacBook, iPad. And the keyboard and the cursor went through all three. And all I have to do is put the items next to each other. That's really cool. Mac also has AirPlay. I had no clue the Mac didn't have that before. Same thing with shortcuts. Also, new Safari updates on Monterey. which they waited till the end of the keynote to mention, but is also on iPad and iPhone too. Safari has a new redesign, so I think that's awesome. It's gonna look really nice, and it's just gonna make it look more sleek and easier to use, not as cluttered on top. So that's gonna be really exciting. And then on the iPhone, the search bar won't be on top anymore, it'll be on the bottom next to your thumb, so you don't have to reach all the way up. So I think that's really awesome. Anyways, that was just a quick recap of the event. I'm gonna make broken down videos about each one, kind of going into depth about those later on this week. So please subscribe to see that. See you guys in the next one.